Family and friends, we have gathered here today in the presence of God to witness and bless Nik and Jess as they become husband and wife. Marriage was created by God and established for our good. It's symbolic of our unity with Christ. It's holy. Because God wants to bless marriage, it's of great importance and value that we take the time to enter into it carefully, reverently, and in the knowledge and fear of God. Into this holy and joyous relationship, Nik and Jess are committing themselves to God and to one another. Being the officiant and the father of the bride presents some logistical challenges. How do I do both? And my wife came up with a brilliant idea of having Jessica's brothers walk her down the aisle and give her away. And that was an inspired idea. And there's a great measure of pride when you see your child grow up and make good choices and work hard and take responsibility as you've done. And your mom and your family have every reason to be proud of the man that you've become. Jess, Nik, you have carefully considered that marriage is a lifelong commitment which God wants to bless. And you're choosing to commit to one another in the covenant of marriage. Nikolai, will you have Jessica to be your wife, to live together in the holy estate of marriage? Will you love her, comfort her, honor and keep her, in sickness and in health, and forsaking all others, give your love to her alone as long as you both shall live?
I will.
Jessica, we have Nikolai to be your husband, to live together in the holy estate of marriage. Will you love him, comfort him, honor and keep him in sickness and in health, and forsaking all others, give your love to him alone as long as you both shall live?
I will.
Who gives Jessica to be married to Nikolai?
On behalf of her parents, we do.
There were many nights when Jess came home from spending time with you and she would say, "Dad, he's so much like you." And I'm not going to tell you if that was a happy thing or an exasperating thing for her at the time. But I know you well enough to be assured that you will love her and care for her above all else.
Jess, I'm so lucky we found each other as young as we did. It's that much longer that we've had to spend together. From teaching you how to fall down a mountain on a snowboard, to something simple like watching you sleep on a late drive home. I have made the best memories of my life with you. I could say so many things about the person you are to me, but I think the best summation of everything would be to simply say that you are my best friend. The way we can laugh endlessly over the dumb things, support each other during the difficult times, and plan for the future are the things that make what we have special. Your presence alone brings me joy. I promise myself to you forever because I know I found the person that will stand by me through everything. Through good and bad, I know you are there for me, and I vow that I will always be there for you. When you are down, I will do my best to pick you up. I vow to be the best version of myself for you and treat you like my equal, my partner. To let you stop and pet every cat that crosses our path. I vow to be loyal to you physically, mentally, and spiritually. But most importantly, I vow that my love for you will grow deeper and stronger than the day before. To always choose to love you, even if it's not easy. Not every day will be easy, but every day will be ours to face together. A apart, I do not think either of us would disagree that we are not perfect. You are my better half, and together, we are perfect. Together we can take on anything, and together we will accomplish everything we put our minds to. Looking forward to the future is daunting, to say the least. No matter how much you plan, there are always twists and turns. Like today, who would have ever thought we'd be getting married during a global pandemic? However, one thing I can say with ease is that taking a step into the future is easy. With you at my side, there is no fear of the unknown. I love you, Jess.
At 18, I thought I loved you. I said it, I felt it, I thought I knew what love was. At 24, I know I love you. I've said it countless times, in the morning, before saying goodnight, when I see you in the driveway after a long day, when we cook dinner. I promise to tell you those words every day for the rest of my life. You are my biggest supporter and my greatest adventure. I love living life with you, the love of my life and my best friend. I promise to share my fries with you, even though it means less for me. I promise to choose to love you, because we both know that we won't always want to love each other. I promise to love you when our life is easy and when it seems hard. I promise to be your number one fan and your shoulder to cry on. I will share in your dreams and your laughter, always looking on the bright side when it might be difficult. I will cherish you and be thankful that I'm so blessed to have you to share my life with. I promise to grow with you and learn with you, make mistakes with you, and I promise to love our journey together. When I inevitably fall short on some of these vows, I promise to make new ones, because as Marshall says on How I Met Your Mother, one set of vows isn't enough for a lifetime of love.
Nik, you may kiss your wife.
Good today. I was freaking out a little yesterday, but yeah, I'm excited today. So I couldn't find my cat today, so that kind of delayed things a little bit. We were like shaking food around the house, like, come on Kylo. He was under the bed the whole time, so that sucked. 6 years this January we've been together, so it's been a long time coming. Nik, if there's one thing I had to tell you, I'm really excited to marry you, and I hope I get to spend time with you today, because yesterday I didn't get to see you a whole lot, so I would really like to be able to spend time with you on our wedding day.
I met Jess in chemistry class my sophomore year of college at Cumberland County College. She was the basic chick at the front of the class in her Uggs with her Dunkin' Donuts coffee every day. And then she was lab partners with a couple of my friends from high school. We started hanging out that way. And we all took a snowboarding trip together, and I taught her how to tumble down the mountain, because I don't think she, to this day, can still kind of pick it up. But we got to know each other that day, and it was nice getting to know her going up the ski lift. If we can get through this, I think we're going to be able to get through anything. Today was hectic, and I think we both held it together. So I love you, Jess, and I hope we, I don't even have to hope, I know we're going to have a great life together.
Ladies and gentlemen, please give it up for the new Mr. and Mrs. Palace!
One of Nik's oldest friends. We met nearly 15 years ago on our very first day of fifth grade when we were placed at the same exact table. It's a pretty memorable day because I got yelled at and a note sent home to my mom And Nik learned curse words that a fifth grader should never say or call the teacher. But Nik and I, we have so many memories together. Most of them actually being at this house. From ziplining off that treat fort to sneaking out late at night to ride our bikes to Wawa to grab Monster Energy drinks. I always knew I can count on him to have a good time. So it's only fitting that we all create a new memory here together. Nik and Jess's wedding day. Nik, I love you, dude. You're my best friend, man. I actually fully love you. And Jess, you compliment Nik so extremely well. It's insane. I cannot wait to see how you two do as a new family. To Nik and Jess, everyone.
There comes a time in everyone's life where they meet their one true love. The one that they can come home to every night after work, relax and watch TV, and cook meals together. That day happened to Nikolai 7 years ago in Mr. Richards' 101 chemistry class, where he met me. Little did he know, 6 years, oh, it was seven, six? Six, all right, excuse me. 6 years later, I was the one to fulfill the vision and take the role as best man, or co-best man. I was lucky enough to see the love between Nik and Jess grow from the beginning. When we first formed the chem squad, ruled the campus Yik Yak page with our Avenger nicknames, where Jess was so excited to open her Cheez-Its that she ripped them open and the Cheez-Its went everywhere. And she was upset because she paid for those. or our late night studying sessions where we would reform our bond that we made in high school. Where Jess became a philosopher and said, no bae equals more fries, but with bae, but bae is better than fries. I'm so happy to be a part of your day. Jess, you make an imprint on Nik's life, but I made an imprint on his leg. Yeah, we could talk about that later. With that, continue making memories and traditions, but remember to stop and cherish the moments. Thank you, everyone, for coming out to the bride and groom.
Cheers. So in the cleaning up of this backyard to make this wedding possible, day one, about minute 17 or 18, best man Dose over there hit my leg with a machete and sent me to urgent care for stitches. So that's the imprint on my leg he was referring to.
Switch things up. So I need all of the single guys, all the single guys out there. All right, here we go. One, two, three. Oh, with the one-handed smash. One, two, three, slice down. Make some noise for him.